When I took chemistry in high school, I asked my teacher, when will I use this? I don't remember their answer, but I bet they didn't expect me to use it for cocktails. Making this clarified daiquiri proves chemistry can be fun. My name is Carl.
And I'm Riley, and welcome to Alchemix Bar, where we will teach you how to improve your home bartending skills.
So today we are going to try a clarified daiquiri. If you don't know what that means, it's basically we took out all the color of lime juice. In November 2019, Riley and I went to Dallas, Texas to visit a friend and go to a concert. There aren't many bands I travel 900 miles one way to see, but Cave In and Russian Circles are two of them. We wanted to have cocktails before the show because that's what you do when you're in your late 30s, but you're still metal. So I Googled the best cocktail bar in the area. Hyde was number one on the list. It was voted best cocktail bar in Dallas, and it was close to the venue. We got to Hyde, and each ordered something different to share with the group. Ah, the good old days. All of the drinks were top-notch, but something stood out on the menu. They were using pH balance and clarified ingredients. We will go over pH balance cocktails in a future episode. I asked the bartender what clarified meant. He explained the short version of removing the color and other impurities of ingredients to help the carbonation process. Fewer impurities mean less resistance to the bubbles. He told me I can get more information from the book Liquid Intelligence by David Arnold, which I happen to have at home. So I've been experimenting with clarifying cocktails since we got back from Dallas. When Cocktail Time with Kevin Koss recently released their clarified lemon juice video, I got inspired again and decided to make myself a clarified daiquiri. We're gonna try side by side, a regular daiquiri and a clarified daiquiri, and see if we can actually taste the difference between this. Let's try the clarified one first. So amazing.
It's weird. It looks like simple syrup by itself.
Or like a really chilled vodka martini.
I think that might be my first real daiquiri. And that's delicious.
It's definitely, it's tart, but not as tart as, like, in my mind, what daiquiris and, like, a mojito and other rum lime-based cocktails are. Mm-hmm. So without doing the comparison, I was like, oh, this is really good. Now let's go ahead and try this and see if we can try it, see if there's any differences.
Yep, the lime is sharper.
Oh, wow.
And the rum burns a little bit more on the back end.
On which one?
On the original one.
Original? Yeah, that one's definitely sharper, tartar.
Yeah.
That one, creamy. I don't know if creamy is the right word. It's not creamy, not like a chocolate cream, but there's like this smoothness, like silky.
Subdued. It's subdued.
Yeah.
It's just like they put a little bit of a filter over it.
Right. I mean, they're both really good.
Yes. I still prefer the original.
The original?
Yep. Because, I mean, I want it to be a punch in the face of lime.
Right. Yeah, I like both. You know, if I went somewhere and they served me this, I would not be mad.
You know? This is visually stunning, for sure.
Yeah, that is like a showstopper. Like, you take that someone out and someone else sees you order it, they're going to want to order that too because they want to know what it's about.
100%.
So this is a fun experiment, right?
Yeah.
We look forward to doing some more of these random things. We do have some other great rum cocktails on our channel. So if you want to check those out, they're going to be listed over here.
All right. If this is interesting to you guys or you want to try it, have you tried it? Let us know in the comments and give us a like. We'd really appreciate it.
Yeah. Let us know a cocktail that might be interesting for us to clarify next. But at the end of the day, thanks, guys. Cheers.
Cheers. Ding, ding.